And welcome back live to SafeMoneyTalkRadio.com. I'm Kathy DeWitt Dunn, along with Matt Redding. Thank you so much for joining our show this weekend.
We got an exciting show, Kathy. It's going to be a lot of fun today. You better listen in, folks. This is really, really cool stuff.
I thought you were going to tell me to listen in. I was like, I have to listen in too. I have
Absolutely.
To listen to you again.
That's right.
Well, we also had a great week this past week. What a fantastic turnout we had for our client event this past Thursday. A little wine tasting and some great appetizers and hors d'oeuvres.
Full house.
It was.
Full house. It was fun.
Do you like that wine?
No, I'm not a big wine connoisseur, but I know you and your husband, Roggy, are, so I'm sure that you probably had a good experience with it. How was it?
It was fantastic. Weren't you there to enjoy it as well?
I was there to enjoy it, but I'm not the wine lover that some people are. So.
Well, we'll get you there one day.
That's right. Maybe a beer event one time as opposed to the wine.
We can do that next time out in Fort Worth. That's where we're going to have
our
next event.
There we go.
Well, we're really excited today. We have a very special guest. We have Dan Slater on the air with us today. And Dan has been instrumental here in the fixed indexed annuity world, designing product. And he's actually designed some of the top annuity products that are available right now in the investment world. Dan, thanks for joining our show today.
Well, hi, Kathy. Thanks for having me on here.
Yeah, it's great to have him. I mean, you know what, Matt? People better get their calculators out today.
That's right. When you deal with actuaries, their mind works a little bit different and a lot faster when it comes to numbers than ours. But it's exciting to have you on, Dan. We look forward to asking you some questions about what you see out there in the marketplace, because you come from it from a little bit different angle than maybe some of our clients would and even we would. So we look forward to some of those questions being answered.
As well. Thanks, Matt.
You know what? Today, I think people are really focused in on retirement income, Dan. And, you know, one of the things we keep hearing out there is that, you know, that guaranteed income rate that we've been seeing all over the internet, whether it be 6 to 10% or 8% compounded annually. And that's a really great product. But what are some of the people really missing when it comes to those guaranteed growth rates for retirement income?
Sure. And I think, you know, Kathy, you kind of said the word guaranteed income. I think a lot of people forget the fact that the guaranteed growth is ultimately used for income. So you think about how that's going to actually play out. When how much income are you going to be drawing when you want that income? And really, is that going to be doing exactly what you want it to do?
You know, Matt, and that's really a great point.
Well, you know, one of the things that, you know, we talk about with those income plans that are out there, they do a terrific job of giving you a specific amount of income for a lifetime. But, you know, one of the things that I know that your firm's focusing on right now is the fact that, you know, demographically people are living longer than ever before, and there's some real needs as time goes on to have an income that can increase during retirement as opposed to one that's just static. Maybe take a few minutes and kind of talk about what you guys see there as far as life expectancies and those kind of things.
Yeah, well, and that's always the joke with my background as an actuary. Everybody thinks I can, you know, predict how long each individual person is going to live. But I always think it's very, you know, some basic things. We all do know everybody's living longer, but really there's a couple ideas. Back in 1980, somebody that was retiring had a life expectancy to about age 80, so it was 20 years. But now, people in the 2000s are now having a life expectancy to about age 90. So if you've always thought about the mid-80s as being your retirement horizon, today it's the mid-90s. The mid-90s are the same as the mid-80s just 10, 20 years ago. And that has a pretty significant impact on how much money you need at the beginning of your retirement.
Right. And that's a great point.
You know, and I think one of the things that I've also seen is that as you get older, Dan, you're going to need more money. So a lot of those guaranteed growth rate plans that we've been seeing all over once again on the internet, really later down the road, people need to understand how that might impact them as far as their goods and services and their purchasing power. Let's talk a little bit about that as well.
Yeah, obviously that's a very hot topic, the word inflation and everything that's going on in our economy. And, you know, you think about the general ideas of inflation, but for people that are in retirement, you're talking about maybe things that even have higher rates of inflation, like fuel and prescription drugs and things that has a big impact. So you really want an income that's growing, not just until you're getting to retirement, but even after you're starting to retire. And I think that's what you're going to really see some difference in products out there is the potential to get growth on your income, which again is just going to really help you against those effects of inflation.
You know, and that's one of the things that we really love about AnnuityWatchUSA.com, because we're able to put income plans together for the investor. We're also able to show them how they can have an increasing income later down the road versus having a static income, much like Social Security, that's never going to go up on an annual basis. But as you get older, you're absolutely going to need an income that is going to continue to go up and not be static.
Yeah, I mean, it's a funny thing. I've actually termed this the illusion of inflation, because when you're buying a plan or an annuity today, you see numbers in the future. And those numbers to you seem like today's numbers, a $10,000 income payment or whatever you're receiving. But when you're 5, 10, 20, 30 years from now, that same income payment may only be buying 20, 30, 40% of the same amount of goods that you're really trying to buy. So again, you really don't see it until you get there. And we know you want to be planned in advance when it comes to retirement.
Yeah, that's a great point, Dan. And, you know, one of the things that you mentioned in one of the conversations that you'd had with Kathy and I was when we were talking about the kind of the actuarial tables or the life expectancy tables and how all those numbers, you know, an average couple age 65, one of them is going to live to, you know, on average, one of them is going to live to 92. But then you also mentioned something I thought was kind of interesting, and that was that people that have money, and that doesn't mean, you know, $50 million. It just means people that have means to do more things with health care and those type of things. When they include all those actuarial numbers, if you have money, you actually, it's proven that you live longer?
Yeah, I mean, that is, Matt, and that's a great point, because a lot of people, I know everybody's looking for information to make good decisions, and everybody's talking about retirement planning, and, you know, people today have a life expectancy to live to age 78 or 80. But if you've already lived to age 60, as you just said, you're already talking about now the potential to live to age 90 or a couple to live beyond age 92. And again, if you have money or you're really in the spot where you need protection, you're probably, again, the life expectancy of that individual is much higher than the average population of the United States. So when you look at a Social Security table or the IRS tables when it comes to life expectancies, that's everyone,
right?
You know, and that's not necessarily a good representation of how long you may expect to live.
Yeah, or somebody maybe in your income bracket or net worth bracket, you know, if you have a $1 million net worth or $1 million portfolio, the likelihood of you living longer than somebody who has no assets is probably greater, is what
you're
saying.
Yeah, and I think even when you're talking an additional 1 to 2 years of a life expectancy, maybe you didn't smoke versus you smoked, certain things like that. Again, going from 32 years to 34 years for a retirement plan may have a really large impact in your ability.
You know what? One of the things that I'm really excited about is the fact that we have so many great plans that are on the market that are now taking a look at longevity risk. And there are some fantastic plans even that you've helped design to help with those retirement years for that average, with that investor that's looking for guaranteed lifetime income.
Yeah. Well, and you know, it is such an interesting thing. Everybody, as we've even talked about it here, the idea of life expectancy. But as an actuary, again, I say this, life expectancy is the 50% chance of living beyond that age. And if you're really concerned about potentially outliving your money, you probably want to have a little bit more safety than a 50% chance of outliving that money.
Right.
So again, I think that just really opens your idea to not just how long I might expect to live, because that really determines how much income you can get from your retirement money today.
Well, you know, and that's a great point, Dan. You know, we run into people sometimes that'll say, well, I've got my income for retirement taken care of. You know, I've got this 5% bond that's out there, and it's going to pay me that income for the next 20 years. But that doesn't really take into account what we're talking about, which is, you know, 20 years from now, it's going to cost you a heck of a lot more money to live. That 5% is not really 5%.
Yeah, and I think, you know, there's a lot of studies out there, and it's a lot of things to kind of work through. But that's the great opportunity with some good education and some good value that you guys bring, I know, to your clients. People can make much better decisions than they've been able to in the past.
You know, but we're real excited today. We have Dan Slater, who's on our show today, who's an actuary that has helped design some fixed indexed annuity products that are on the market right now that are designed for retirement income and will help you with inflation and will also give you better purchasing power later down the road. If you would like to log on today to annuitywatchusa.com and request your income illustration, or sign up for our webinar this next week, we're really going to educate all the investors out there on what you could achieve for your retirement income, to stay up with inflation, to see some solid rates of return, and to have principal guarantees. Again, the website's annuitywatchusa.com. We're going to have two webinars this next week. You can also schedule your free appointment today on our website. If you're 59 and a half, currently working in the Dallas-Fort Worth area, you need to give us a call or log on to our website, because we can help you with your current 401k plan and roll that over. You can still contribute. It's a non-taxable event. Or if you have a 401k plan at a previous employer, did you know you can also roll that over? It's a non-taxable event. There's so many great opportunities with this volatile stock market right now. Wouldn't it be great to have peace of mind, to have an income that will stay up with inflation, that will give you a better purchasing power later down the road? Well, log on today to annuitywatchusa.com or call us right now at 972-473-4700. That's 972-473-4700. This is Safe Money Talk Radio with Kathy and Matt. We'll be right back.